What up, beauty gang? Today I'm bringing you guys a super realistic everyday makeup tutorial that anyone and everyone can easily achieve. It doesn't require contouring, foundation, false lashes, none of that. So this is a legit everyday makeup look that even those who feel they're less skilled in makeup, like myself, can create in like 5 minutes. Because the everyday makeup tutorials I see circulating around YouTube tend to be very unrealistic to me. I don't know about you guys, but some people's everyday makeup for them is pop-out makeup to me. So if you feel me on that, then I'm sure you'll find this video super helpful and relatable. So just starting off real quick, I am tampering with my lace front Beauty Forever hair. This is their Malaysian deep curly hair. If you are interested in the hair, go ahead and wait to the end for some of the hair's details. But right now I'm just kind of setting the hair by spritzing it with water and brushing it through with my tangle teaser to make sure that the curls are popping by the time my everyday makeup is done and I'm just, you know, ready slayed to go. Just a really quick routine that is, again, easily achievable for anyone and everyone, especially like this hair. It's not high maintenance at all, in my opinion, if all you have to do is spritz water on it and brush it through for the curls to be popping. And even you saw a couple seconds ago how the hair was prior to me spritzing it. It still looks beautiful when it's big and curly. So yeah, right now I'm just gonna go ahead and set this hairstyle, specifically my little cowlick that I got in the middle of the part, and I'm gonna tie my hair back so it doesn't get in my face as I'm doing my makeup and whatnot. So we all done here with the hair for now. And then I'm gonna go in with my Huggies Natural Care Wet Wipes. That's what I use now in the mornings to clean off my face if I decide not to wash it with soap. And now in the next scene, as you can see, my brows are already done. I have plenty of videos already on my channel of how I achieve my brows. However, if you'd like me to do an updated brow routine, I'm down with doing that. Just make sure you're commenting this emoji below and smashing that like button. Now moving on to the lashes, I am using my Essence Get Big Lashes Volume Boost Waterproof Mascara that I got from Ulta for only $3.99. I think this is some of the best cheap mascara I've ever gotten. And when I say it makes my lower lashes, my bald lower lashes pop, I mean pop, y'all. So if you're interested in getting this, I did get it from Ulta Beauty. And yeah, I just make sure I double coat both the bottom and top of my lashes because that's what really gives your lashes volume. Then I'm gonna go ahead and clean up any leftover mascara residue with a Q-tip. Y'all know I'm the Q-tip queen. Clean that up and then apply a little bit of concealer over top of that area, because in the previous clip I did apply some concealer along with blending it in with a beauty blender to kind of make my eyes look more awake. So just in case I rub some off of the Q-tip, I kind of reapplied some and blend that in. Now I'm going in with my Wet n Wild gel eyeliner, and I'm just going to put that inside the waterline of my eye on both the top and the bottom to kind of just close in my eye, give it more dimension and pop, you know. So as you can see, my lashes and eyeliner are done. Now I'm going to the lips. I'm using my Black Brown NYX pencil to line my lips. Y'all know I'm all about the line, and a lot of people be trying to go in on me saying that it looks awful, that it's doing too much. I guess it just doesn't fit with the generational trend, but if you guys haven't noticed by now, I'm very much so a 90s beauty type of person back when beauty was more simple. So I'm gonna keep lining my doggone lips. That's what I like to do. Now continuing on, I am highlighting my face, the brow bones, my nose, my high cheekbones with my NYX eyeshadow in the color Lavish, as I always do. And it's so funny because people always be asking me, where'd you get your highlight? Like, oh, your highlight is popping. And it's freaking eyeshadow. It ain't no $30, $40 Anastasia Beverly Hills or what is it called? Becca Cosmetics. It's literally a $5 eyeshadow, if not cheaper. But yeah, I blend it in with a beauty blender because I feel like that's the best way to blend in highlight on my face, since I don't use like foundation, so it can't really like mesh together. And yeah, now the makeup look is done. I'm gonna go ahead and untie my scarf now that my hair has set. And it looks pretty popping to me, if you ask me, if I do say so myself. So I kind of like swooped out a little of my own baby hairs and tucked the hair behind my ears. Now the last touch is to add my earrings. Really hate going anywhere without earrings. Like this video or comment below if you can feel me on that one. And yeah, ladies, our look is complete, boo. All
right, you guys. So just wanted to tell you a couple deets on this hair. This is Beauty Forever hair and their Malaysian deep curly, and I have in a 20 inch frontal, and I ordered 222 bundles and 224 bundles, but I only use 224 bundles along with the frontal. As you can see, the hair is full, so had I used 3 or 4 bundles, it would have been huge. And I am a fan of huge hair, but at the same time, 2 bundles and the frontal, I feel like, gave me a lot of fullness. So I really love this hair. I love how soft it is. It is beautiful hair, you guys. Like, beautiful. beautiful hair. This is some of the softest curly hair I've ever had. And as you saw in the beginning, it's very easy to manage. You spritz water on it, brush it through, and the curls are popping. Or even in the beginning of the video, like, I really didn't have to spritz it. The curls were still beautiful and just full without it. So it depends on what you view as hair maintenance. If you think that you have to spritz it all the time to get really defined curls, then the hair is a little bit high maintenance, but not really, because all you have to do is spritz water, brush it, takes a matter of 2 minutes, and then you're out the door. So this is very low maintenance curly hair, which is rare. A couple of things that I do want to mention though, after I bleached the knots on this frontal, the hair on it shedded a lot more than it did prior, which was really interesting. So it's kind of a pro and a con, because it can shed a lot and then look less and less dense the longer you have the wig. Whereas on the other hand, when you're customizing and plucking the frontal, it helps it look a lot more natural, because it's not as difficult to pluck out the hairs. Another thing with the frontal too, the curls on the frontal were a lot bigger and less coily than the bundles, I noticed. I mean, obviously you can't really tell now because I spritzed it and brushed the hair together, but just wanted to mention that. Oh, and then one more thing. I've always noticed that my Beauty Forever lace frontals have always been like so bomb and so natural. Like how flat it lays, it's just impeccable. Like, they make the frontal dense enough to look natural, but not over dense where you're like having to pluck all this extra. Like, and that's what I really love about their company. So again, this is Beauty Forever Hair and their Malaysian Deep Curly, 120 inch frontal, 224 inch bundles. And yeah, you guys, obviously it's in the color 1B. But yeah, if you have any other questions about this hair, don't hesitate to leave in the description box below. The links to the website and the hair and all that good stuff is also going to be in the description box below. And yeah, until next time, guys. Bye.